Street art to me is a vibrant pulse of London. It's the most important thing to see. It's, you know, everywhere you go now, it's just so ordinary, so boring, everything the same colour, all these corporate buildings going up and down. But I think people need a little bit of colour in their life, a little bit of joy. So it's a joy of real life show. And it's like our natural nature growing out of the walls of the city.
Street art doesn't have to be explained. No, it's like you can give. Everyone can make like their own opinion about it. You can really see what it is.
You can't make a designated area for street art because that's not how it wouldn't work like that. There has to be a sort of certain informality to it, but I don't think it should be everywhere.
That's the thing with street art as well. You go to an exhibition because you know who you're going to go and see generally, whereas street art, you're just there and you're appreciating probably 10 different people all on one street, which is really great.
What I would say, it's a diversionary therapy in the sense that by the time you are there, just watching it, taking photographs, takes you away from your depressive situation.
For me, the art of today isn't stuck in some cold gallery somewhere. It's on the walls of the city. It's vibrant, it changes every day, it comes alive every day. There's always something new to see on every street, really.
To me, it's colours. No meaning to it.
It depends what it is. It can be vandalism, it can be ice. It has to be a matter of someone's personal taste. But normally, if someone just written their signature on a blank wall for fun, that's not art to me.
I just do street art, but I have such a big love for the boys that do go and paint trains. You know, part of the art is having one eye on the piece and one eye over the shoulder looking out. I was tagging a long time ago, kind of on the streets, sneaking out. I like the excitement. I don't really do that much stuff anymore. I like to spend time on a wall, so I'll go to a wall with a bunch of colours and have some fun. But I guess the way I got into it was tagging. I then carried on drawing. I did more characters than I did letters then, and that kind of developed and evolved. And now I'm where I am now. So.
Like art is subjective. You like it, you don't like it, you don't like it. There's always going to be haters and lovers, and that's the end of it. You've got to do
it's
what
like
you
Marmite.
Want to do.
Exactly.
Like Marmite. Exactly. Marmite on bread all day long.
I won't say I've got a favourite piece, because there's so many pieces out there, you really have to go and discover it. I found one the other way just off of Brick Lane. I'm obviously a fan of the man called Prince, so I saw a nice tag on a place called Salvation just off of Brick Lane. It's just a simple piece of art. The door said Salvation across the top. It had his, you know, image there and the sign, and to me it was kind of like I now identified, and when Prince, they identify with that space as being an artist who feels the same as you, has expressed himself, and you understand the emotion behind that piece. That's why you can't tell you whether it's tagging or not.